Yes. Okay. So men need to look like Jesus. The problem is, in the church, we've defined who Jesus is just by the Gospels. But the storyline of Jesus begins in Genesis and goes all the way to Revelation.
Wow, that's good.
So when we read about Joshua and Jericho, we teach that in our churches. So you're a Joshua, and what's your Jericho? What's that thing that's in the way? No. Joshua was pointing to the character and nature of Jesus. Mm. Jesus is the true and perfect Joshua who would overcome the biggest barrier, the Jericho of sin, sickness,
right,
disease,
right,
and death. But Joshua did not come in to honor Jericho. Joshua came in to destroy Jericho.
Yeah.
That God was glorified through the destruction of a city.
Wow.
You see, the problem is that we define Jesus as this guy with feathered out hair and Birkenstocks. He'd
right.
go from town to town saying, yay, consider the lily of the, you know. And we forget that Jesus wasn't a nice guy. And we've got this nice guy syndrome in the church where we think, I'm just going to, and here's the thing. My wife doesn't want Darren to be the nice guy.
Right.
My wife wants me to be a man of God. A Christ man that you see from Genesis all the way to Revelation, that the fullness and the character and nature, that the bravery, that the courage, that this is what we need to see. The problem with the word love, like I hear this word love being used so much in the church right now, is it is the most under, it is most overused and the most under, the misunderstood
right.
word
yeah.
in our vocabulary.
Yes.
I love my iPhone.
Right,
I love my car.
Yeah.
And we need to be loving. And we are using this word massively out of context. For God so loved the world that he sent his own son to die.
Yeah.
To be shamed.
Right.
And most people in our culture would say, well, that ain't love.
Right.
What kind of father would allow his own son to die? So, yes, we there needs to be love, but there needs to be a depth of love. And especially, man, I have conversations with men in our church, and they feel this pressure. They feel this pressure to be, like, loving, and they feel this pressure to be, like, at rest. This another big thing that's been in the church right now is to be at rest. And you got men that are living under condemnation and shame because they're working their butts off right now.
Right.
And so we're using these words, and we need to truly look at Jesus.
Yeah.
That Jesus, it was the pattern son, and Jesus worked his butt off.
Yeah, he did.
He had a work ethic, that the Bible begins with God working and building, that Jesus lost his temper.
Right.
He fought for stuff.
Right.
He bled for us. So men, we are called to weep deeply. We're called to bleed. We're called to lay our lives down. We're called to get angry. Like this is what it looks like. The men on the front lines, we are a man of passion and valor and anger, that righteous, holy anger that we are being moved.
Right.
And so that's what in a passive church is a dead church. Absolutely. And there will be churches that don't reopen.
Yeah.
And there are lines that are being drawn in the sand right now. And I pray that men would at this time seek first the kingdom and his righteousness.
Yeah.
And all these other things would be added. So Lord, I want to think like a king.
Yeah.
That's what the kingdom is.
Yeah.
That men, we
That's
would
right.
think like, I got a palace. I don't want to just work for the man. I want to become
right.
the man.